Hello, this is Charles Lloyd, and you're watching First Look.
Hello, I'm Don Was, president of Blue Note Records, and our guest on First Look today is the venerable maestro from Memphis, Charles Lloyd. He's a visionary, an innovator, a master musician. Many of you watching this have been longtime fans of his. He's been one of my heroes for about 55 years. And one of the great joys of my gig at Blue Note has been getting to know the maestro and witnessing his brilliance at close range. And just when we think that it will be impossible to top the genius of his previous albums, he delivers a knockout right hook like this year's unparalleled masterwork, Trio of Trios, a set of three individual albums that present him in three different trio settings, with each album originally intended, for the sake of solid numerology, to be released 3 months apart, although it looks like, for practical reasons, we're going to condense that a little bit. The record one, called Chapel, features Charles with guitarist Bill Frisell and bassist Thomas Morgan. Record two, Ocean, features him with guitarist Anthony Wilson and pianist Gerald Clayton. And record three, Sacred Thread, offers a trio with guitarist Julian Lage and percussionist Zakir Hussein. A trio of trios, three LP deluxe box set, is going to be available exclusively online at the Blue Note store too. And it comes with a hardcover slipcase for the whole set and four lithographic prints featuring the brilliant cover artwork of Dorothy Darr and a signed lithograph featuring the box set artwork. Maestro, thank you so much for being here today.
Amen. You're my guy.
It's good to see you, man. We'll talk about the new records in a minute. But before that, I want to tell you that when I see you at age 84, still searching for uncharted territory in musical expression, it inspires me. I learned from it. It makes me practice more, and it makes me want to keep diving deeper in music. And I think non-musicians can learn from your example as well. I want to talk about the never-ending pursuit of excellence.
Well, I got years of experience, you know, but at the same time, I'm blessed to have beginner's mind. So I'm never satisfied or never about to sleepwalk or anything. You know, I like the flight, you know. I had a friend in high school, Ezel, and the swimming pool in Memphis was only open for us a little bit in the summer, and we couldn't wait to get in, but they had the water in the pool before the summer swim session started, Orange Mound Swimming Pool. Mm-hmm. And the hip guys would climb under the wire at night and go for a swim. You know what I'm saying?
I do.
Those who know, those who don't know, you know. Those who know don't say, those who say don't know, you know. So anyway, one night Ezel went in and went up on the high board and did the 2.5 that he could do. There was no water in the pool.
Oh, jeez.
So Ezel went to a place where, from his brain thing, he would just be laughing all the time. He didn't go to school anymore. And then I thought, wow, because he hit his head, you know, and he didn't come back the same. It's like when we play, we go exploring, we don't come back the same, you know, it's different.
I got to spend
some time, because there's some eternal verities that I haven't touched yet that I'm anxious to get to. All I can do is keep serving the music, and it's still a music of freedom and wonder, and I'm blessed to be a part of it.
Well, you're doing a beautiful job of it, man. I think we're going to divide this discussion into three parts, one for each of the trios. So for this first segment, let's concentrate on the Chapel Trio. How did this group come together? And let's talk about what that first concert was like.
I'm a singer. And Bill Frisell, quiet as is kept, is a singer. Mm-hmm. And so he heard me play in Denver when he was a little kid in high school. And he said, it opened up his file cabinets and stuff. And he saw there's another way to do this, you know. So Bill has been close to my heart for a long time. I didn't know that. And then When we played together, I said, I'm looking forward to us singing together. And he just loved that metaphor, because I'm not trying to be kitten on the keys. I want to sing a song, you know. I want to share some light, you know. And I always said, I don't know if you ever saw my album, what was it, Voice in the Night. I said, I want to change the world. I want to bring beauty because there's so much ugliness out there. And that was then. I thought by now we would have a beautiful paradise planet and we would all be loving each other. And man, it's a botheration to my nervous system, the way things go. I had a residency in Montreal and Jason and I were doing a duo, Jason Moran. And then Bill was there and he was in the wings and I invited him to come and play. And it was like the synchronicity was beautiful. And I knew that we were supposed to sing together. And that's what we do. We just started making space in our schedules to be together more and more. And then he has a deep friend, Thomas Morgan, and they have this wonderful intuition thing going on. Mm-hmm. And so I thought the three of us singing together would be something beautiful because Thomas is very special. You know, he approaches it, he's all music. And then one day Bill told me that he and Thomas had a listening session where they were just listening to all my recordings and they were, you know, lifted up. So I knew then that Thomas would be the one to go on this voyage with us.
One of my favorite tracks from the album is Billy Strayhorn's composition, Blood Count. I think it's the last piece he ever wrote, right? Let's talk a little bit about that one.
Well, I saw Billy Strayhorn in 1966 with Duke Ellington in the south of France when we played at Antibes Festival. I visit Strayhorn and Duke often because they're our holy grail guys, you know. Duke, our indigenous art form, we stand on their shoulders. To be around Strayhorn and Duke and those guys, it was cathedral and simple living and high thinking. They were great geniuses. And so I feel a part of that tradition and I want to make a contribution.
No, it's a beautiful version of the song. Let's listen to a little bit of it.
Thank you.
That's Charles Lloyd from the new trio album, Chapel, Blood Count. You took the classic 1960s Cuban cabaret ballad, Ay Amor, which I know from a Pedro Almodóvar film called The Flower of My Secret, and you completely reimagined it. Tell us how that one came about, man.
Well, this is very strange. I have a fan in Estonia, and she sent me a version of this. And it moved me very deeply. And I played it for Bill. We were on tour. And it was with a Spanish singer. I can't recall who the singer was. And then we started playing. It's just because it told a truth in a deep way that was like our ballad tradition. And yet he had that amoroso thing from the Latin quarter, you know. Yeah. I just stumble upon it.
It's beautiful, man. Let's play a little bit of it.
Please. Thank you.
That's Charles Lloyd with Bill Frisell and Thomas Morgan from Record One of the Trio of Trios collection entitled Chapel. We're going to take a little break here and then come back to discuss the second trio album, Ocean, in part two of our first look with Charles Lloyd. Thank you, Maestro.
Thank you, sir.
If you enjoyed First Look and would like to see more, please hit the subscribe button and also click the bell icon. That way, you'll be notified when we post our next video.